coffee and conversations with the one and only J-Man. Your morning will never be the same. Here we go.
When the road gets dark and you can no longer see, just let my love throw a spark, baby, and have a little faith in me. When the tears you cry
Good morning. You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa, that's right, Alexa can make it do what it do. Let me give a shout out to those that's in the chat room. Good morning, Yogi. Thank you so much for being on this morning. Nurse Rachel, thank you so much for being on this morning as well. And all of my warriors out there at Emory Winship Cancer Center, good morning to you all. I hope you all had a great weekend and that your week has started off great. I know it's going to be a wonderful week for you all. I feel it in my bones that you all are going to have a great, great, great week. To the trainers out there, the doctors, lawyers, psychologists, psychiatrists, receptionists, everybody that works out there, good morning to you all. Thank you all so much for helping my warriors out as they're training to be better. So good morning to you all as well, and to everyone that's listening that is not in the chat room, good morning to you as well. Let's just go ahead and dive into it. My question this morning is, do you know where you are and do you know where you're going to? Do you know where you are and do you know where you're going to? I forgot who sung a song. Do you know where Diana Ross had a song with those words in it? I've been in a place lately where I wondered where I was standing and where I am going. I wondered where I was standing and where am I going? How did I get to where I am? And then which means I had to reevaluate my life. I had to reevaluate my life from every aspect, because if I'm going to get the fullness, the full answer to why am I here, where I'm standing, where my life is currently, I honestly have to take a look at everything that I've been through in life. I feel that we have to be honest with ourselves about where we're standing, where we are in life. We have to be honest with ourselves. Because a lot of times we blame others for our position. We blame others for our position. Not to negate that stuff happened, not to minimize the fact that there were some things that happened to us that was totally out of our control. Not minimizing that. But what I am saying is that our response to everything that we have encountered in life, period, good, bad, and ugly, where we are in life is an image, it's a mirror image of how we responded to it. Some of us live, for instance, I'll go this way with it. At the age of 19, I had to make a tough choice. For some of you all, this season in life was not as hard as mine to me. I graduated high school and I'm sitting on the edge of my bed. And as I'm sitting on the edge of my bed, I ask myself this question: what's next? And so as I sat on the edge of the bed, I thought about college. I'm already graduated from high school. I just graduated from high school. I had no preparation on college. I didn't sign any application. I didn't even look at one college. Because I had to make a decision. If I go to college, I'm just going to waste somebody money. I already knew that if I went to college when I was 19, I was completely wasting somebody money. It wasn't my money because I ain't have none. And so I made a decision on my own, without talking to my mom, without talking to anyone. I walked about 3 or 4 miles away. I literally walked there. And I stood outside of the military recruiting offices, looking at Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines. I am 99 pounds soaking wet, which means I'm not even 100 pounds. And I had to make a decision about my life. It was that decision. I ended up going to the Navy. It was that decision that some 25 years later, I ended up retiring from the military. And now this very day, I don't ever have to work again. I have a nice paycheck coming in. All because I made a decision some years ago. Now, there are other decisions that I can talk about that also were negative decisions that harshly impacted my life. Largely, let me use the word largely. Largely impacted my life. And so here I am today looking at a kid, 19 years old, who's now in control of his own life, his own destiny. Forget about all of the stuff that happened to me before high school, including all of the stuff that happened to me before high school, before I was at a place where I'm making my own decisions. And so today, as I sit knocking on 50 in December, I'll be 50 in December, I am grateful for everything that happened to me. I'm going to help somebody out today. I hope I do. I am grateful for everything that happened to me today. This is including every bad thing that has ever happened to me. Did I want it? No. Was it easy to get over? No. Am I still dealing with some of the stuff? Yes. But when I look in the mirror, I've gotten to this point in life. Finally, I've finally gotten to this place in life that everything that has happened to me, I found the good in it. I found the good. Now there, I hear you. I hear y'all. Well, this happened to me. Molestation happened to me. Rape happened to me. This happened to me. I got beat up. I got bullied. I got this and that. I'm including all of that conversation. Not that you wanted it, because what I shared with somebody earlier this week. This past weekend, I found myself involved in a conversation about relationships. And a lot of people value my opinion, and I'm often grafted into conversations. And this particular place that I was in grafted me into this conversation and asked for my opinion about it. And they asked me, you know, well, what should we do? How should we? I told them this. I'm not too keen on telling people what to do. But in this area. But if you want my opinion, I'm going to share with you what not to do. There were some things in my life that I did, that I carried, that happened to me, that I did to other people, whatever the case may be, I'm going to share with you what not to do. Some of the hard spaces that we found ourselves in life, some of the hard seasons that we found ourselves in life, was not about teaching you what to do. It should help somebody else out. Maybe, just maybe, those that are struggling with things that and you all have not been able to get over, maybe that season in life was designed to teach you what not to do. And we've harbored unforgiveness in our heart because of stuff that went on through certain season in our lives, and we damned people to because they did this, that, and other. Instead of saying, you know, this happened to me Ask yourself, what did I learn? What did I, as now that I'm older, what did I learn from that experience? How does that experience help someone else? Here we go. Here we go. Let's ride then. For those that believe in God, and we say, I am a gift. God made me. I have a gift on the inside of me. Well, a gift is not intended for itself. If you wrap a gift up and put it on the Christmas tree, if you wrap a gift up and put it on the table as a birthday gift, the gift is not meant for itself. The gift is actually meant for someone else. If you are a gift, you are meant for someone else. Your story, your life story, your ups and your downs. Don't get in a place in life where the only time you share your testimony is when all of the good stuff happened to you. Sometimes, if not all the time, you need to be sharing your story of the bad stuff, your testimony that is not a pleasant taste in your mouth, because you survived it. And your testimony and what you went through in life is going to help someone else survive what they're going through. Someone is waiting on you as a gift to get them through. I'll help you out in this area. To get the most out of life is acknowledging I went through stuff that did not taste good, but I survived it. I went through things that I didn't ask for, I didn't want, I didn't desire. I'm trying to figure out why me? Why did this happen to me? Why did that person do this to me? Why did I lose that opportunity? Why did I lose that investment, or whatever the case may be, however you want to shape it. Some of the stuff that you went through came to you, if you believe in God, because he said you were strong enough to handle it. He said that you were strong enough to handle it. The only way you're going to get the victory out of this, the only way you're going to get the release, the mental and emotional and spiritual release out of this, is accepting the fact I went through this for a purpose. I often tell people and I share with people that a lot of sicknesses in our body is literally caused by stress. When we are stressing over things in life, especially over things that we would never see a different outcome from, that we desire to see from it, we would never get the apology. We would never get the person. We would never get a chance to cuss that person out. We would never get, because they go either dead in a grave or moved on and don't even remember your name. But we have decided to just stay in that season in our life and not let things go. My brothers and my sisters, I beg you to let stuff go. Begin to let stuff go. Learn how to let stuff go. As beautiful as you are on the outside, make sure your outside matches your inside. Let me help you all out, because this just hit me. You know how much money we spend on making the outside look good? I have a monthly subscription, or monthly membership, I should say, where I pay a certain amount a month that I can make a call anytime and get my my beard and my face and my hands and head done. Pay good money for it. Ladies, y'all pay good money for makeup and and weave or wigs or whatever you all use, the different stuff. How much, and now they're doing the body parts and all of this other stuff that we spend so much money on making the outside look good. Imagine if we spend a lot more energy and focus on making the inside look good. Imagine if we did that. Imagine if we got to a place in life where I cleaned up the inside of me. I cleaned up my emotions. I cleaned up my psyche. I cleaned up my spirituality. And now not only is my body looking good, but my mind is looking good and my spirit is looking good. Can you imagine if we spent more time taking care of the inside, how much less money we would take in spending on the outside? I was talking to a group the other day, and one lady said that one of her friends, she did not appreciate her looks. And she spent lots of money taking care of what it looked like. Got the BB something. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Spent money on the makeup. God bless her soul, Little Kim. I don't know when the last time y'all seen Little Kim. Bless her heart. But what we knew of her in the beginning, she looks totally different now. And Michael Jackson was another person. Looked totally different because what they saw on the inside, what they was trying to do on the inside, on the outside, what they was trying to do on the outside is make their inside look better. A lot of times what we do on the outside is a direct reflection on what we're trying to actually correct on the inside. So my brothers and my sisters, my conversation this morning is make sure that when you look in the mirror, make sure that when you look in the mirror, you love the person that's in the mirror. And the person in the mirror is the one that makes you happy. Stop looking for people, places, and things to make you happy. I'll say that again for the people that was in the back that was talking. Stop looking for people, places, and things to make you happy. Work your happiness out on your own. Anything else that comes your way, any person that comes your way, any place that comes your way, or anything that comes your way, is only going to enhance how happy you are or add icing to your cake. It'll add icing to your cake, but you're already happy. But you have to find that inner peace. You have to find that inner glow. You have to find that inner beauty. And getting to that place where I find my inner beauty, where I find my inner peace, I have to acknowledge every phase of life that I've gone through. I can't brush anything under the rug anymore. I have to accept the fact that this happened to me. That happened to me. Over here, I made a great choice. And we're quick to acknowledge all of the good choices that we've made. And we've collected that into a repertoire of conversation topics that we can have. But baby, if you learn to take the things that you made, some bad choices you made, and say, I made this choice right here. I did this right here. And I learned this right here. This over here happened to me. I didn't want it to happen to me, but it happened to me. And I didn't like it at the time, but this is what I learned from it. This is the conversation that you have to have with yourself. When you have that conversation, please hear me. When you have that conversation with yourself and acknowledge all of the good, bad, and ugly that has happened to you, and learn all of and absorb all of the lessons that that season gave you, you will find a better purpose in your life. And you will find, I'm standing where I'm standing right here because everything that I went through directed me to this spot right here. Sometimes this spot right here is not a good spot. But I landed here because of everything I went through. And if I landed at this spot right here, that means that I'm tough enough to take care of it. I'm tough enough to go through it. I'm tough enough to handle it. The word tells us that yea, though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, that yea, though I'm walking through this physical illness, yea, though I walk through this financial difficulty, yea, though I'm walking through this relationship difficulty, yea, though I'm walking through this bad family issues, and the list can keep going on and on and on and on about where you are in life, you're only walking through it. And as long as you don't acknowledge it, you're not walking through it, you're standing in it. Don't stand in it, walk through it. Maybe that's what somebody needed to hear today. Don't stand in it. Don't stand there and just and weep and throw yourself a pity party. No, walk through it. Okay, this is the test for me right now. Let me go ahead and knock this test out. I'll share the story with you, and I'm done for the day. Some years ago, we would earn different badges, pins for our uniform in the military. And mine was the Fleet Marine Force pin. That was the pin that I was trying to get. And they told me, they said, if this particular person is going to be on your board to test you, they're going to give you this piece of paper. And you have to be able to write all of the helicopters in the Marines, how many people are on this helicopter. You're going to have to learn what type of weapons on this helicopter. What does these different planes and helicopters hold? What do they do? Where are they located? You have to do all of that on this one piece of paper. And so I prided myself in preparing for this test. So when the day finally came, sure enough, that person came into the boardroom to give us this exam. He slid the paper to me, but because of what I did in previous months, I was prepared for it. In less than 5 minutes, I filled out this form and slid it back to him, and he looked at me. He said, "There's no way you're finished with it." He said, "It's impossible that you finish with it." I said, "Well, everything is filled out because I've already prepared for this particular test." He looked at it. I did not make one mistake on it. Did not make, because I what I went through in my past prepared me for that time in life, that one moment in time. I'll say this to you all, that thing that you went through in life, all the stuff that you done went through in life, has prepared you for this moment that you're standing in right now. I open the conversation up with, where are you standing? Do you know where you're standing? And do you know where you're going to? You don't know where you're going to if you don't know where you're standing. You don't know where you're going to if you don't know where you're standing. If you don't, it's like being on a track field. Are you standing in the blocks for 100 or 400 hurdles? Why are you there? Always remember, whatever you went through in your past season was designed for your very moment right now. I hope something that I said today help you all out and give you some encouraging words, however it may have helped you. I pray that something I said has helped you. Thank you all so much for listening in. I would definitely see you all later on this week, Thursday. Be good and be great. Holla at your boy.
I've been sad, I've been lost, I've been down and I've been lonely. Yeah. I've been suffering at a job in a world that tries to own me. But when I wake up every morning, there's an image of a better place. Yeah. Cause the harder that we grind, then the sweeter is the glory. People say I'm foolish. People say I'm blinded by faith. But if I run out of air, if I crash, I don't care. I'm gonna do it my way. I can make it through this. You can throw the world in my face. But the fear gives me life, and I swear till I die, I'm gonna do it my way. Put me down, criticize me with your lies and with your parody. Yeah. In the darkness, I don't hide, cause I got pride that gives me clarity. I still wake up in the morning with the vision of a better life. See, the option of defeat's just not written in my story. People say I'm foolish, people say I'm blinded by faith. But if I run out of air, if I crash, I don't care. I'm gonna do it my way. I can make it through this. You can throw the world in my face. But the fear gives me life, and I swear till I die, I'm gonna do it my way. I don't care, I'm gonna do it my way. I can make it through this.